What were your dreams as a young girl?
You know, as a young girl, they were really very, very simple. I'm almost embarrassed to say. I used to dream about working hard and long enough to buy a little piece of property so that everybody in my family could live on the same hill, mm-hmm. and that we would have enough to eat and roofs over our heads, mm-hmm. and that we were always close together. And I'm talking like aunts, uncles, cousins, brothers, sisters, mothers, fathers, everybody. I wanted them all together and safe, because I think for a lot of years it didn't necessarily feel like it was always very safe or mm-hmm. very secure. And so that was my dream.
Mm-hmm. And tell me a little bit about, I read that you went to UC.
University of California, yes.
And it said that that you had four kids before you finished your bachelor's.
I did.
Yeah.
You know, I was really very fortunate. I mentioned that my father had been very sick over the course of his lifetime. He worked with his hands, and he had several surgeries that made him disabled. They had to do a lot of surgery on his spine, and mm-hmm. so as a result, he ended up completely having a spine fused. He couldn't get a mm-hmm. job anymore because he was like 90% disability rating, and so I wanted to go out and get a job. So I wanted to graduate early from high school. I was the oldest again, trying to make sure we had enough to eat. And a high school math teacher said, no, you should go to college if you want to make a difference for your family, something I hadn't even dreamed about. Mm-hmm. My parents had dreamed that their kids would graduate high school because they hadn't, but mm-hmm. they never thought about college either. So as a result of this high school teacher helping me to find scholarship money and convincing my dad to let me go far away to go mm-hmm. to school, I ended up going to the University of California in Santa Cruz. And before long, I met a really great guy who I married. And between my junior and my senior year, I started up having kids, which mm-hmm. is not necessarily the great order of things, but you know, the truth of the matter is, I don't think you can always understand why God sends you in certain directions. I'm blessed with four beautiful children. Mm-hmm. They were born between my junior and senior year of college, and after I was finished having them, I went back to school. I finished. Mm-hmm. So it's not always about, you know, understanding where you're going to be 5 years from now and drawing a straight line and then following that path. Mm-hmm. I believe that God has for us each a certain set of expectations and goals and plans, mm-hmm. and He wants you to use your gifts to make His will happen. And so ultimately, I ended up finishing college and going on to graduate school with those same four kids. And they used to go to class with me, and they'd ask questions. When the professor would say, do you have any questions? They'd raise their hand. But I think it was a good thing for them.
Like, there's a lot of girls that might have kids at their young age and think, oh, my life is over.
Exactly.
But
it's not true. And unfortunately, there are a lot of young girls who are even younger than I was. I mean, I started having children when I was 20. There are a lot of young girls who find themselves having children at a very young age. Life is not over. Mm-hmm. And in fact, I think part of being a very good parent is planning for and expecting and believing in yourself and working hard and having faith that God has a plan for you, and that you got to put all those things together mm-hmm. to find what that answer is, what your life is all about. Mm-hmm. But an important component of that, I really truly believe, is that you find a way to make sure that your children have what they need. Mm-hmm. And a lot of that is the love, support of their dreams and their goals.